esportsbets.com, a unique place for true gamers. The only place to bet on esports events. You know your way around a competitive gaming scene and are willing to take a risk? Watch regular broadcasts and earn real money. esportsbets.com. Foresight, passion, and calculation.
All right, and with that, ladies and gentlemen, we're hopefully getting a little bit closer to actually being live here with the grand finals. As you can tell, there's just one admin currently on the server, but I'm told the players are making their way to the stage, so we should be all good to go. Semla, this is going to be one hell of a finals, isn't it?
Oh, yes, man. Oh, yes. I'm here. We're ready to go. It's the finals that we could have predicted would happen, but, you know, we were guessing for a while. Hellraiser's really putting up a fight with NaVi in the consolidation final for third place. But Hellraiser's are taking third. My XMG are taking fourth. Now we see who takes first and second, and it's going to be a perfect best of three. Fnatic have looked indomitable this entire tournament long. They just look untouchable right now. They are the team to beat. Now the question is, have NaVi figured out how to unleash Guardian, basically? Can he be the man to take point for them?
This is the thing that I just sort of thinking about, you know, because I think everyone can agree that Fnatic is the favorite team, not just because they have a one map advantage, just generally because they've been playing really beautiful and great Counter-Strike for a while now. So that's what it's down to. And NaVi have had various issues. So I was trying to think, what are the reasons that you could say NaVi might be able to win? And obviously Guardian being one of them. But then when you really start thinking about it, in the beginning, in the first day of this tournament, actually the two people that really surprised me on Navi's side were actually Staryx and Seuss. Not because they mad fracked, but just because they played well above their own level. And that was incredible. That means if they do that, Guardian does what he does against Hellraisers here on Mirage, and then, you know, Seized becomes everything that he could be. This could be one hell of a fight for Fnatic. It's by no means sure that they're going to be able to win it, even with the one map advantage. Actually, just going through the maps as well, just so everyone's clear on what the format is here, because it's a best of five grand finals. Fnatic came through the upper bracket, having won all the games so far, and they have a one map advantage. So it's Mirage, Inferno, then Train if it goes to a third map, and if it does, then it'll be a coin flip between Dust 2 and Nuke as the final map. And that's how it works out, guys. So we'll have to see.
That coin toss again for NaVi. Right?
Oh, yeah.
So, I mean, one thing to keep in mind is that Fnatic did do very well versus NaVi on Mirage, which is going to be the first map of this series here, but we saw them play it out yesterday as well, and Fnatic took that map 16-11, at least in the recent results, right? So, one thing that's cool, and that's, I mean, you've already pointed it out, you just pointed it out, Zeus and Staryx, right? But the last time we saw them perform very well like this was the last Star Series. So I think that Star Series really has a positive influence on Zeus and Staryx in particular. Guardian just seems to be the point man for NaVi, no matter the situation. The one man that I'm kind of looking for, or at least looking to really step up his game right now is Seized.
Yeah.
Because
yeah.
Seized was like the MVP, basically, of the last tournament of Star Series. I mean, he beasted every team that NaVi played against. But we really haven't seen him show up in a big way this tournament so far. So I'm wondering, you know, if the grand finals is the time for him to wake up.
It would be perfect. And I mean, we've seen this before. Just think back to Gamescom in Cologne not that long ago, where NIP ended up winning basically because they peaked exactly when they needed to, right? Because for a large part of that Gamescom tournament, let's be honest, NIP did not look all that impressive, and actually it wasn't even clear that they were going to make it out of the groups. And that, you know, maybe NaVi could go through a similar transformation. Maybe, you know, now is the time they're going to step it up. They're certainly going to have to, because I don't think Fnatic are going to come, you know, sort of sleepy into this grand finals. I think they're going to be super hyped and prepared. And if NaVi give them even half an inch, they're gonna take this whole grand finals.
Oh, yeah. That's the thing. It's going to require flawless play out of NaVi, basically, to shut down Fnatic. Fnatic are the clear favorites going into this. NaVi are capable. Now we just have to see, you know, does everything come together for NaVi for them to really put up a fight here versus the Swedes, who, you know, have had all day, basically, to watch NaVi play as well. So, you know, they just got to sit down, watch NaVi play that best of three and be like, okay, this is kind of where they are right now. That's going to be a lot of information going into this grand finals that Fnatic now have lined up.
It really should, right? And I think the idea of being able to watch your opponents for like a whole day before you play them, it can be really good. It should be really good. As long as Fnatic don't sort of, you know, put too much weight into what they've seen, because they don't want to be caught in a situation where they're playing off of how they think, you know, NaVi's going to be playing, and then it turns out they're just adjusting a little bit. So I don't actually think Fnatic is going to fall into that trap at all. I think Pronax is going to be plenty smart to just play his own game and, you know, and not worry too much about what NaVi are doing in that sense. But it does probably give them a little bit of an edge, especially, I think, maybe in pistol rounds, because if NaVi have already shown some of their tricks, and we've seen that they have, pistol rounds could have to play a little bit different for NaVi, so they maybe can't do the same things that they did earlier.
Yeah, there is that edge that they can get because they've watched NaVi. What I'm worried about is Fnatic basically coming into this best of five cold, because they haven't had, you know, the best of threes like NaVi, like Hellraisers, right? Where they were able to warm up, and it took a while for NaVi to start getting a hold of what Hellraisers were throwing at them and being able to deal with that. And then Guardian basically took it, you know, in his hands, his mighty hands to make it happen, basically, for NaVi, and took control away from Hellraisers. And that's where NaVi really turned it around and started to dominate that best of three. Are we going to see the same picture here with Fnatic? Are Fnatic going to take a map? Are they going to need time to be able to, you know, get the juices flowing before they can start dealing with what NaVi are going to throw at them? Because you can be sure NaVi are not going to waste any time. They're going to come out swinging.
I mean, I guess for NaVi, it's kind of cool that Mirage is the first map. I'd say that's a map where they have a decent chance of beating Fnatic. No, by no means 100%, but I think, you know, if they get off to a good start and they win on Mirage, then it's kind of 1-1 in maps, and we sort of equalize the Grand Finals a little bit, and it's going to be more interesting from there on out. I do want to remind you all that we do have a subscriber giveaway also going on. We already gave one Deagle away today, and we're going to be giving away also one of these StatTrek AKs that you can see right here. So those are for the subscribers. Big thanks to everyone for subbing. And also, because Stoney is a madman, he actually gave us another Cyrix. He apparently opened it, like, yesterday. So we have this Cyrix as well for a giveaway. We're going to have to, I don't know, get a picture of Stoney and put it on a wall somewhere, because he's like the MVP of gifting us stuff for the giveaway. So we really do appreciate that, Stoney, once again. Makes a big difference to us, and obviously we want to try and keep our subs as happy as we can, basically. But, I mean, I guess asking who you think is going to win is a little bit redundant. I think the same choice is Fnatic. So I think actually, I think once again, it's best for us to sort of enjoy it and look at how much of a good start NaVi can get up to, basically.
Essentially, I think the start is going to be pretty important here, and the knife round is going to be very important for both of these teams. I think NaVi really need that CT start. Make Fnatic work for it right from the start. Don't give them the easy edge, the CT start, where they're going to be able to, you know, air quotes, have an easier time of things, right? NaVi need that, really, I think, to build the confidence going up against the Swedes and to really just, you know, maintain the momentum on their side of the court or of the field or of the map or whatever. But NaVi, I think, it's more important for NaVi because Fnatic have just a mountains of confidence going into this match. I mean, they got runner-up at Gamescom, just barely losing out to NiP. Very close series, but it's really up there as to how well Fnatic have been performing with this recent addition of Olafmeister and Krims, who, we have to say, are pretty goddamn scary on this map. Because LGB were not a team to be taken lightly at all on Mirage. It was a real pleasure to watch them play. Fnatic as well were very good, especially when Mirage was first released. They were the team to watch. A lot of the teams were studying them, trying to figure out how they were playing Mirage because they were just that good at it. So the combination of those two, the Fnatic core and the LGB members, really makes Fnatic scary on this map. They know it down to a T.
Yeah, I absolutely agree. And then the sort of the raw fragging power of Krims and Olafmeister makes it really tough to deal with. And I think what's even more scary is that I think those two alone makes Fnatic a hard team to deal with, no matter what, you know, map you're on or what day it is. But then, because JW has had a really good tournament already and has really been hitting some sick shots, that's a really hard sort of trifecta of players that's really hard to beat, right? I mean, that's almost too much.
Yeah, JW is the wild card for me for Fnatic. Like, Flusha is consistent. Pronax has been having a very good tournament. I mean, we've seen two best of threes from Fnatic so far, and Pronax did well in both of them, especially versus MyXMG, the first best of three that we had yesterday morning in the semifinals. So Pronax and Flusha just seem to be consistently good right now for Fnatic. Olafmeister and Krims, I look to really get solid results. Krims in particular has been doing fantastic since he joined Fnatic. Like, Olafmeister's kind of hit or miss because I think him and JW are still feeling out who's going to do what, really. Like, who handles which situation, that sort of thing, right? So, Krims is really the one who's been blooming on this new Fnatic lineup. JW, though, that's the thing. It's like the JW-Olaf kind of conflict, but, you know, the fact that they kind of do sort of, you know, fill the same role sort of thing. Olafmeister, I think, having to take the back seat. And when you have to change up how you play, that affects you. And I think we've seen that with Olaf. It's kind of hit or miss with him.
And then I think the really, I guess this, if you know, I'm not playing against them, so it's not annoying to me. But I think if you're an opponent playing Fnatic, then the really annoying part is that sometimes, even if you get into a good position against them, you know, you get into like that 2-on-4 situation, you feel like you have it on lockdown. Someone like Flusher just can be the guy to just like pull off a 1-on-3 or something like that. And that can be really frustrating if you've already struggled to kill the rest of Fnatic and try and get into that position. Then Flusher is kind of a crazy ace to have up your sleeve in that sense too. So there's just a lot of resources on the Fnatic lineup, and that's one of the reasons why they've made their way kind of effortlessly into the grand finals. I mean, it's not completely without any bumps, but they did kind of cruise in here, and once they got control of everything, it seemed like they were never going to let go of it.
When you get down to it, it was really that last map. Well, Mirage was somewhat close. Mirage was definitely more of a fight put up by NaVi. Inferno was just very Fnatic-sided, where they really just kind of broke NaVi. So really what I'm hoping for here is that NaVi, they didn't really have that much of a break, but that they were able to talk over the kind of errors that they made yesterday and are going to be able to kind of adjust to what Fnatic are going to throw at them today. You can be sure, though, Pronax, the mastermind, he's got... I don't think they used everything yesterday versus NaVi to take this win. The win in the winner bracket final, right? I still think Pronax has got plenty up his sleeve. So even if NaVi have had a night to kind of figure it out and try and plan it out in their minds, I think Pronax is still going to be able to catch them off guard pretty thoroughly.
Yeah, and I mean, especially because the way Pronax calls a lot of the time, at least in my opinion, is you know, that mid-round calling. And really, when you're good at that, that's not really something the other team can do anything about. It's not like you can, if Pronax was good as an in-game leader because he ran really elaborate strats that had, you know, three different stages. First we throw some flashbangs, then we push and take this part of the map, and then we do, you know, 10 other things. That's something that you can, you know, counter, because you can identify when it happens and you can sort of see what the next stage of the strat is and try and prevent it from happening, right? But what Pronax does is simply saying, I have a pretty good feeling that, you know, right now the right call is going to be the B bomb site based on information from my team and just experience. And he's right a lot of the time, and that's hard to deal with for any team. And that's great. I mean, that makes it tough.
Oh yeah, it definitely does. It's the marriage between a pick style and a strat style, and being able to just call out and shift between the two. Because you watch JW's play, and on this map in particular, but also in Inferno, I mean, JW's role on Fnatic is to kind of go out, and he's the one who's kind of given free reign to go out and do what he wants. That's always going to be JW's role, what he does, because that's how he knows how to play. So Pronax is always going to give JW his head and be like, go, just go get kills. Have fun with the op, have fun with the shoddy, whatever, just go do something. And then it's going to come down to the rest of them to kind of shift around what JW's throwing around. So that's what makes Fnatic such a difficult team to deal with. Like, sure, okay, you can peg down JW, you can lock down JW and figure out what he's doing, but then you got to deal with the other four guys who are most likely going to destroy you too. So good luck with that. But it looks like NaVi will have picked up the knife round, so they do get to pick which side they start on. And I'd be amazed if they went over to the T side.
Yeah, they're going to stay. So a big welcome and a big thanks to every single one of you for joining us. This is the SLTV Starseries Season 10 Grand Finals. We've got NaVi and Fnatic in a best of five with a one map advantage for Fnatic. So welcome to Room on Fire, of course. I'm Anderson, with me Semla and Vendetta. Well, he's going to be joining us hopefully a little bit later, but he had some stuff he had to take care of. And, I was missing sort of half the day as well. So that's quite all right. We'll bring him back as soon as he's available. And, of course, remember to follow the channel. We're actually now about 4,500 followers away from hitting that 200,000 mark, which we've been sort of gunning for a while. So bring us up there, and we'll be really happy. And a big thanks to all the subs as well for helping us out. That really does make a big difference. We're just waiting. I mean, obviously, they're huddling right now. They're getting ready for it. But once that's done, the action is going to probably just start and never end, right? I think it's going to be a really brutal matchup because, I don't know, both teams rely quite heavily on you know, a couple of their players having really good aim as well. So we should be seeing some interesting duels.
But both teams are very smart on Mirage. That's why I think this is going to be so much fun to watch. Both of these teams, Fnatic already demonstrated in the first match versus NaVi, where NaVi really felt like, okay, they were pushing very hard. And Fnatic was still able to keep their cool and net that win. I think it was like 16-11 to score, right? But a lot of the plays that we saw on that throughout that map was Fnatic really just showing that they've thought out a lot of the different scenarios that they found themselves in. They knew what to do, and they kept their cool and acted on that. So that's crucial. What we have to see, I think, is NaVi really try and throw Fnatic off their game. somehow find a way to, I don't know, unleash the G-Rex or get, you know, seized out there just doing his thing. But like, they need to find a way to get in Fnatic's face and throw Fnatic off their game early on here. And CT side start, they should, if they can just deal with the early offensive here from Fnatic in a strong way, it's going to be really tough for the Swedes.
I mean, it definitely will be very tough. And, you know, just looking at, I was looking at CSGO Lounge earlier. Not because I didn't dare to bet on this match. It's too scary and too much at stake, basically. But the betting tendency is actually 19% in favor of NaVi and 81% in favor of Fnatic. And I think, if nothing else, that is not quite reasonable, in my opinion. That's saying that if you replay this Grand Finals, 10 times, then NaVi is only going to win it 2 out of 10. And I don't think that's true. I think I'd be more inclined to say like 65% in favor of Fnatic or something. 80, I think, is too high.
Yeah, definitely. That's a bit too much of a stretch.
I'd go 65-35 or something like that, I think. I'd be okay. 60-40 as well, I'd be okay with that. But 65-35, I think 80-20 is too much. But
yeah, definitely like 65-35, I'm kind of down with that. Like, NaVi have a chance. It's just really going to demand everything from NaVi. Like, NaVi have to play some of the best CS they've played all year if they want to take out Fnatic here in these finals. That's what we have to see. And they're capable of it. They're definitely capable of it. It's a question of whether, you know, everything comes together. Zeus manages to make the right calls. Guardian hits the right shots. He hits his flow, right? And seized Edward. They just kind of get in there and shred. Zeus and Starx hold down the sights like they're supposed to, like they did at the last Star Series LAN. You know, all these things have to come together for NaVi to really take on Fnatic, but it's going to be good, guys. Strap yourselves in. Get everybody in to watch this as well. This is the grand finals here of Star Series. 2 days running, 4 teams, and we're down to the final 2 now. And we get to see who's going to walk away with the big first place check.
Yeah, I mean, Fnatic, they fell just a few rounds short against NIP in the Grand Finals of Gamescom in Cologne, so I bet they'd be happy to take the Star Series Finals here. And NaVi, they're the defending champions, and they're on home soil, so obviously they want to, you know, keep the title and throw Fnatic back home to Sweden. So there's actually a lot on the line here for both teams, I would say. And yeah, we'll have to find out how it's going to end. I guess, right, they're taking an extra long time, actually, to do this huddling up here, I guess. I guess that's also an indication of how seriously it is being taken here.
They are definitely taking this serious because, and there's another thing on top. Not only is it home turf, right, as you said, Fnatic knocked NaVi out of Gamescom. They made it into the playoffs. Fnatic runs into NaVi in the quarterfinals, and it goes down to the 30th round of Nuke. And Fnatic take that and knock NaVi out of the last major. So you can be sure that NaVi have a bone to pick with Fnatic right now. They've definitely looked at what went right, what went wrong in that match. They've done their homework. Now, you know, so NaVi, there will be blood. This is going to be perfect. There's so many stories coming together right here between these two teams. There is so much on the line.
Most definitely. And C's is saying go, go. Is Fnatic ready as well? Right now, we're still waiting a little bit. They seem to all be there except for Crims, maybe. So just any second now, we should be ready to go. I mean, I have a feeling that this might go actually to all four maps. I have a strange feeling that it might happen.
Well, cross your fingers, man.
Yeah.
Knock on wood. All four maps would be legendary. That'd be perfect right here. I feel like it has to be settled on all four maps. But it's up to NaVi if it is. Fnatic will be starting on the T side here. First map of this best of 5. NaVi on the CT side. And now let's go ahead and look at what. Oh, never mind. They're shooting each other in the face. So don't. Yeah. Let's not look and see what they spend their money on. We'll wait until they actually start.
Yeah, be a sick mind game if you start off by killing one of your teammates and then you actually are still alive and the other team assumes you're not and then you just kill them. I've always wondered if anyone would have the guts to do that. That would be like the biggest statement.
It's like, we'll take you 4-on-5 and we'll win. Like, think about how you're going to feel about that if you actually lose that round and you're the guy with the man, you're the team with the man advantage.
Well, you ever seen those, I mean, those plays in, like, American football where they pretend that they think there's been a fault or something, like, you know, there's been an error, and so they all just pause around and wait, and then all of a sudden they're actually live again, but, you know, they've just been pretending. I guess that can happen. Now, look at this rush coming in here from Fnatic. They're pretty quickly towards this bomb site, but there's 3 people holding, and they even have a grenade here on Starix, which could be used, except for the fact that he throws it into the ground instead. Now, Caesar is going to be peeking against a lot of people, and he does get the 1 kill, which is pretty important.
Nicely done there by Flusha. They give up Olafmeister, but Flusha is in there, and now it's going to be Starx holding. Edward is there from his spot on short, gets the instant headshot on Krims. Great kill there for Na'Vi. Now they've got the man advantage. The bomb is yet to be planted, and everybody is here from Na'Vi. Bomb on the site. There's not a hope. There's not a prayer for Fnatic. They need to land some of the sickest shots of their lives, and it's just not going to happen. Zeus will find JW, and it's all down to Pronax. The bomb will get defused, and Na'Vi will secure the first round of this half.
Whoa, that was very scary because, first of all, even if the grenade had hit, it would have been mistimed for Starix. It was still a little bit funny. But I think the fact that Seast got picked off, he was really far out and sort of in the middle of the hallway. That could have been instantly a really bad round for NaVi. So they managed to adjust, and even if the bomb went down, Fnatic, they couldn't hold on to it. I mean, NaVi were quick on the rotation.
Yeah, they were very quick. They did not waste any time at all. But just some great shots coming in as well from Na'Vi. Edward, long distance, picking off Krims like that. Seized managing to take out Olafmeister before he could get double teamed. Like, that, those key kills had to come in for Na'Vi to take that round, and they did it just perfectly. Fnatic are just not even wasting any time. Straight onto the B site here. Three members from Na'Vi, and this should be a slaughter. Na'Vi shouldn't lose a man, although Edward is doing his best to die early.
Yeah, JW will pick up one kill here, and now he's going to have to reload. He's got six bullets left, so he can actually find Edward. I have no idea why Edward is even wanting to challenge. Just leave it up to Guardian to pick up that triple, and they will. That kind of push was actually something that worked for Fnatic earlier in the tournament towards the B bomb site, so I'm not even surprised that they go for it, because they have really good flashbangs, and they could have caught Na'Vi off guard, but they don't, but they will still not be able to buy this round, actually. They did put down the bomb in the pistol, so that's interesting.
Investing in the round somewhat. They're just wanting to make sure that they have everything. I mean, Fnatic, they're still a team. I think they need like five or six rounds, right, on this T side. So they've still got plenty of time to get those rounds. So I don't think Pronax is under any kind of pressure right now to get anything, any results early. Like, they're like, okay, we'll just try and probe, see if we can't get Na'Vi to spend some money here in the next round. Great double spray by Edward on short is going to take out Pronax and Flusha. And now Olafmeister up in B apartments. He's been spotted out. Edward knows he's there and just casually picks up his third frag.
And the bomb is all the way back in T-spawn, basically, so I'm not even sure what Fnatic were wanting to do in this round. I'm very confused about how the Swedes are playing at this point in time. Oh, well, that's a really great 1D coming out from Krims. I like that. It's going to take down at least one player here, and JW wants to find another headshot on Starux, which actually would kill him at this point, but there's going to be a grenade, and JW is going to be gone. So Edward with a triple and a double kill from Starix, and right now, actually, look at this. The top three members from Na'Vi Semler haven't even died yet.
Yeah, that's the big thing I was about to point out, is that Fnatic, another reason why they probably didn't buy that last round is because they just haven't been getting kills. Now, they have three kills across the entire team going into the fourth round. So, you know, these kills are it's kind of important because, you know, every kill you get, right, that's $300. So that's an HE nade, that's a smoke nade. You know, that you know, plus $50, that's helmet right there, you know? So, I mean, like, Fnatic not really getting the kills early on.
Wait, are we pausing because Olafmeister spilled Coca-Cola all over his place? I think he did. Ah, that's the best reason to pause. I love this.
What? I hope he didn't get it on his keyboard or anything like that, because that's going to actually take time. If they just have to wipe everything up, it's going to cause Olafmeister to be a little bit uncomfortable. There you go. Apparently, it was HR with Red Bull.
Yes, apparently Hellraiser has had the same problem with the Red Bull, and it's Olafmeister's turn to slow down the show here.
Nice, Olaf. This is all a strategy, actually, so that Pronax can have an extra, you know, minute to talk over what they want to do. Right. Like, okay, guys, this is what we've seen so far. This is how, you know, okay, we're going to go hit here, right? Pronax has already mapped it all out in his brain.
I mean, I think it's a little bit too early to do tactical, like, puppy-style poses, right? A little bit too much. They're only 3-0. It's not really a big deal for Fnatic. They're going to be able to bring it back here, but... it's a fun conversation going on. I appreciate that. Well, big welcome if you're just joining us here, of course. You're just in time for the grand finals, so welcome each and every one of you. Invite your friends, and let's see if we can break some sort of crazy viewer record. Actually, what is the record for sort of online? Or I guess this is a LAN tournament. We're still doing it as sort of an online cast.
65,000, I think.
65? Is that our channel record as well?
Yeah.
Oh, so if we can break 65 today, that'd be interesting. I would appreciate that.
Well, we got her. This is a LAN final. This is a sick best of five between two of the best teams in the world right now. I certainly hope people are going to start tuning in. We're starting to get into prime time, too. It's getting later on in the day. It's Sunday. Everybody's being nice. You know, they're going to go and eat breakfast with their grandmom, have brunch with the family, you know, all that jazz. But now it's time to get home. Now it's time to crack open, you know, a beverage and enjoy some good CS on a Sunday evening going into next week.
Sunday, right? It's a great time to be watching Counter-Strike. Actually, pretty much any day is, but I guess right now there's like a it's like a certain calm. And actually, you can't even be outside, at least not in Denmark. It's been raining so like insanely across Denmark for basically the last 12 hours. It's just been pouring down. So all you want to do is stay inside anyway, and that's good.
Keep it down there, man. I don't want it. It's nice and sunny over here in Sweden. It's cold. There's a bit of a nip wind blowing through, but it's not raining. Keep your rain. I don't want your rain.
Well, we generally do it, you know, almost every day in Denmark at this point. They're not quite ready yet, so let me remind all of you, while we're waiting for them anyway, that we do have some subscriber giveaways. One of these is the Cyrix that we're going to give away thanks to Stony, and we also have a Blazed Eagle somewhere. Oh, sorry, no, StatTrak AK. That's where this is confusing. I'm going to do it like this instead. We also have one of these StatTrak AKs that we're going to give away. So, two lucky subscribers can get to win there. We already, earlier today, gave away one of these deagles. So, yeah, big thanks to everyone for subbing, and we'll try and give you guys something back for your effort. It really does help the channel a lot, so that's why we keep emphasizing it. And that's pretty much it. Oh, man, this is... It's a bit frustrating having this kind of pause early on, but I guess for Fnatic, I mean, I actually don't know if it'll help in all that much. I don't think it makes a difference. It's too early in the game for anyone to have gained, like, a massive amount of momentum. I think NaVi are smart enough to not going to be on, a great high from winning a pistol and two rounds after that. They're going to be happy, sure, but I don't think they're going to be, like, feeling the victory anywhere near yet.
No, I don't think so either. I mean, it's still, this is still going to be a long series. There's no getting around that. You still need to win two maps if you're Fnatic, and three maps if you're Na'Vi. Like, that's really brutal for Na'Vi. Like, you need three maps to take the win. That's a lot of games. That's a lot of time that you have to be pinpoint on your energy. But it looks like, all right, enough rambling. Fnatic is ready. Na'Vi are ready. We're going to get into it. And this is a crucial round, because this is the fourth round bye now coming out from Fnatic. What they've saved for the past two rounds, it's all going to happen here. And there is no... Excuse me, there's no AWP picked up here from on JW or Olafmeister. It's all about the rifles right now.
Yeah, it is all about the rifles. And Guardian this makes does me think
a
AWP.
Smoke play, man. This makes me think a smoke round coming out from Pronax.
And that's a pretty good thing to test, right? Because you never know. I mean, that this really stand. You're absolutely right. This standard A push is so common, but, you know, sometimes it just works anyway. So you might as well just try and see if you can make it work and break now with something that isn't even too flashy, but just kind of common sense at this point.
Well, we got the smokes going up now. Flashes, smokes, Starks holding very close to pit right now. However, as Fnatic come rushing out, he's going to go ahead and catch JW. He almost gets two, but Krims is able to react in time, pick him off, and turns it into a 4-on-4. Guardian with that AWP, though, is around, and he's going to get one before getting double sprayed. Pronax catches him completely off guard.
Yeah, Zeus goes down as well. That's going to leave Seized here, and he's in a really awkward position outside of the smoke. He's going to actually flash into CT spawn trying to fake it, but now they obviously know where he is, and now Pronax is going to take the long trek around after having picked up a triple. This is a 1-on-1 with 8 and 7 HP. It's almost funny, right? Because it's so ridiculous. One bullet from either player is going to be enough.
They're gonna fake each other out too. Or it's like the bluff, but it's not getting called, right? C's just like, I know you're coming back to A. And Pronax is like, I'm going to be so clever right now. He's never going to see me going for A. This is perfect. 30 seconds left, though. There's still time. But I like C's position. He's relying on his ears at this point. If Pronax tries to come in through mid, he's going to watch there. And if he hears the bomb plant going down, he'll know it's going to be A. So he's not leaving himself exposed to get shot at by Pronax. But neither of these guys has an HE. It is going to come down to the rifle.
He can just spray through here, but he's going to be walking up. Pronax has no idea, and that's such smart play from C's, to be honest. Just waiting right there. Didn't question himself at all, which is something that could be really rough, I think, on some players. Once you wait in that corner for more than 20 seconds, you know, I guess it's just like human nature to start doubting yourself and thinking, maybe I'm at the wrong spot. But C's didn't, and that's going to win them the round. And a very important round here for Na'Vi.
Yeah. Yeah, both of them so low there. That's a big, you know, that's actually a mistake from Flusher, though. get not managing to land the spray on seized that he went for, and it's very uncharacteristic of Flesha to miss a shot like that, because he was really dead on top of seized and just couldn't land the final, like, the final killing blow. So we'll have to see if they're going to be able to recover a little bit if Flesha, you know, shakes it off and gets into this game big, because Fnatic have enough money for another buy round thanks to that that bomb plant here.
Guardian pretty flashed or pretty smoked out in that window, but he's going to try and take some shots anyway. Doesn't connect with anyone. Fnatic can still buy. Right now, something that's really scary is the fact that Edward is at 7-0-1, and I don't know. Edward hasn't been the most flashy player, I think, overall in the history of this Na'Vi lineup, but the few times where he's gone truly bananas, it's been insane. Like, he can be like a secondary Seized or Guardian or something like that. And if you think all the way back to Edward's 1.6 days, that's not really a surprise. Edward is a star player in that sense.
No doubt about it. And we saw it was on Inferno the last time we really saw him get, you know, cut loose and drop a 30 bomb. So we'll have to see if on Mirage he's able to do the same. He is absolutely capable.
Yeah, I definitely agree. It's sometimes actually almost a mystery why we don't see it more often, him going that crazy. But now would be a good time. It's Grand Finals time, right? Already Edward, though, speaking of him, maybe we cursed him. He's down to 8 points of health, and it's going to be an A push again, but a delayed one, and a very slow one here. Even for Fnatic, this is kind of slow. 25 seconds, and they do get the opening kill. Olafmeister comes in with a shot on Edward, and 2-for-nothing trade here, and another one. Great headshot for Olafmeister. It's going to take down Seuss. He's going to go for a third, and he's going to get it as well. Just a one-man army at this point, and Seized. It's in a 1-on-5 here in the CT spawn. He's going to go down to Crims. A flawless round for Fnatic.
That was really nice, and it was good to see Olafmeister wake up as well, because he was sitting there 0-0-4, and I was kind of starting to get a little leery, thinking, Olafmeister, you know, what's going on? You know, is he not able to find the shots? Has he just been in the wrong place at the wrong time? So it's good to see that he's got his game face on, and, you know, he just walks in there and single-handedly opens up that A site for his team. Really nicely done. Na'Vi still have enough money to go for a buy here, and the important bit is that Guardian has enough for an AWP straight up. AWP Kevlar, no nades. So let's see if Guardian can step up to the fore now and really shut down Fnatic, because Na'Vi have been relying on him very heavily all day long.
Oh, so both Guardian and JW missed a shot. I think actually Fnatic had an interesting plan there with simply smoking Guardian off from the middle, and then JW was ready to catch him and he fell back. It's a nice idea, but he missed the shot, unfortunately. And Seized has a scout all the way over at the B bomb site, which is not that much of a bad idea. I think we touched on this earlier. You can actually use the scout pretty effectively on this range.
Oh, yeah. We're naming it the Shangir scout from now on, by the way.
If you're playing
B site Mirage and you go scout only, this is the Shangir scout.
I'm up for that. Sean deserves it as well. That was a sick play from him.
That was ridiculous. Oh, man. It's still one of the highlights, definitely, of the whole tournament. Oh. There you go! Seized. Peekaboo. Headshot on Pronax, and Guardian finds Crims at the same time. Flesha manages to return, however, and take out Zeus, but Starx and Guardian get another 2 quick kills. Na'Vi. JW is going to find one, but it's not going to be enough quite yet. 35 seconds left on this clock. That's not a whole lot of time for JW to act.
No, it definitely isn't. Weirdly, Starix has managed to sort of circumnavigate JW, so he can actually walk into the A bomb site. Starix is going to come back, and maybe just in time, JW is going to get spotted and caught out here. And that's what the jumping scout's all about. Sean Gares would be proud. 5-1, and we're going to be moving into the 7th round.
That was really nicely done, and that actually, I mean, this is the thing. Na'Vi, we cannot count them out at any point in this tournament, in this best of five, because they are capable of rounds like that, where everybody just lands the shot, and it's a high-pressure situation, your money is on the line, and your first half, practically, is on the line, because Fnatic, if you eco in the face of Fnatic, they will not let you get away with it. They will press and get many rounds off the back. So Na'Vi, they saved themselves from losing a lot of momentum in this first half. They managed to actually put Fnatic now in that tight spot where Fnatic are the ones worrying about ecoing the next round if it doesn't work out here for them.
Yeah, they do put up that smoke that's meant to help you get out of the apartments, actually. Pronax, is he going to be burning? Yeah, he's actually going to lose some HP as well just from that Molotov. And burning some time off the clock here as well. But I like this setup from Na'Vi. I think this is going to be really tough for Fnatic, but they're going to go for it.
No fear. They decide to make the play after all. Pronax with the bank smokes and the bank splashes, and they're going to go rushing out. Edward is holding right below them. Seized is already spotted. Pronax, though, already the kills. And this is basically Pronax, the sacrificial lamb. He's just thrown himself out onto the B site to sell the fake?
Yeah, actually.
Look at the rotation from Na'Vi.
Yeah, they're moving out of the bombsite too soon. Now they have to get back in, and Fnatic, are they going to be on point? Yeah, JW picks off one, almost controls the spray. Edward's still alive here and has a little bit of time to reload. He needs backup quick, though. He's going to peek, and Flusher will be there to pick him off. So now it's a 3-on-3. The bomb will go down, and that's all off Meister. Let's see if he can pick up a couple of kills here. He's certainly hiding very close to the bomb right now. And NaVi trying to make their entrance. Olofmeister doesn't connect that time. Guardian is going to take down one of his friends. And now it's Crimzalone in a 1-on-2.
And he's boxed in. He eats an HE nade, drops him down to 5 HP. And Guardian, Guardian Starx, the combination of the two is just overwhelmed Fnatic in the end. Olofmeister having some pretty big opportunities, but can't capitalize on it. And so I just really, that is a very cool play from Fnatic. For Pronax to just chuck himself out there, make it look like he was going to be like the diversion, whatever, that the actual action is, it's a nip play, right? The action is going to happen on A, guys, and NaVi just take the bait completely. It's such a shame that Fnatic actually don't pick up the round off the back of that strat, because we haven't really seen that before.
That could definitely work. I think that's a very, very cool idea, and it was close at the end. I mean, it was down to 3-on-3, so that in itself was pretty good. They had the bomb down too. Couldn't quite finish it out. And it's a small hiccup almost at the end where both NaVi members thought the other one was going to defuse. So that can actually be really dangerous. This time, it wasn't such a big deal. But if you're down to mere seconds, you don't want to have any question about who's actually going to be defusing.
No, seized with a great spray control. He should have picked up three there. And as the flash clears, yes, we can see. Seized, three notches on his belt. He picks up a fourth. He goes for the fifth. And it's going to be the anti-eco beatdown ace. Seized, very nice work keeping his cool and controlling the spray.
And again, you know, confidence right now in favor of NaVi, 7-1. And Fnatic, it's not like they've been playing badly either, but they are actually starting to lack in the kills department. Right now, if you take the, I guess, you know, almost the top, you know, actually the whole of Fnatic team almost has as many kills as, you know, the two top fraggers from NaVi. So right now, I think Fnatic just needs some entry frags. They need to get some kills on NaVi here.
Yeah, that's when it comes down to it, it seems to be NaVi, like Guardian, basically, just stepping in, picking up frags that are opening up, allowing NaVi to just build off of that momentum. And he continues to just deliver right now for NaVi. It's been several rounds in a row. Fnatic are now reeling, essentially. They've lost Pronax, but then again, you know, it's not the hugest loss. Pronax is now going to be able to really just focus on what his team is doing and guide them. But there's four guys gathered up here on the A site for NaVi. They've really committed to this. They're leaving Guardian alone towards B, saying, Guardian, you take care of apartments, it's all on you. The rest of us have to lock down A, and this is going to be brutal if Fnatic run in here.
Yeah, this is almost like an Inferno-type play where you just put everyone in A. It's really interesting that NaVi are going for this, and it should work out great. I mean, Fnatic are going to have such a hard time doing this, but they do open up on Edward. And now, actually, Creams has a great chance to backstab here. Fnatic are making it work anyway against that whole defense. They just rush in and get it done. Smart play, a great play from Fnatic. Now, Guardian is in a 1-on-2, and he's going to make it a 1-on-1. And Flusher won't die into the grenade. He's probably going to get the bomb plant too, but how does he get out from behind this box without Guardian taking him down.
This is how. The flash. And now he sets it up to be able to spot out Guardian. Guardian has got confirmation from him, however. Flash goes off once again. Guardian, oh, just misses the opportunity to catch Flusher getting into CT. And now life gets very difficult for Guardian. This is a situation that Flusher should not lose at this point.
Guardian also flashing himself. Not really ideal. Gonna break it once and goes for the spray. He has still got 50 points of health left. Flusher surviving for such a long time. Guardian gets the kill. And I think he's not going to have... Is he going to have enough time?
No way!
Just in the last second! That's ridiculous! Guardian, it looked like Flusher had done everything right, just surviving, but it was a nanosecond away.
I'm speechless. I take it back. Well, there was the chance, but Flusher played that about as good as it gets. Staying alive like that from the second that the bomb gets planted, and nearly the entire... He nearly lives the whole time, buys almost... Oh my god, that's so close. That's going to be heartbreaking for Fnatic. Because, I mean, you're on one round, you think you've got a second round in the bag, and then Guardian does it a split second. Like, the split second he needs to get that defuse, he somehow finds it. And NaVi are now up 8-1. They still have enough money to go for a full buy on NaVi's side as well, whereas Fnatic, they've really just got to spend all of their money. Great play here from Wolfmeister, though, catching Guardian off guard, and they're already out on B site, so Fnatic not wasting any time at all here.
Yeah, NaVi actually leaving the B bomb site completely undefended, and Guardian missing a huge flashbang there that maybe would have helped him out. Now Flusher picking up in the middle, and I think NaVi kind of maybe got a little bit overzealous at winning so many rounds in a row. that they just kind of forgot to take it too seriously, and that's something they just can't afford to do. This may seem like it's really one-sided, but it's going to be certainly 8-2, and there's nobody, it's not written anywhere that Fnatic can't make like a sick comeback and push it all the way to 9-6 or something like that. NaVi's really got to be careful.
Look at the money for NaVi, though. There's only one guy with significant bank.
Yeah.
That's Guardian. And the rest of them are all sitting really low on Na'Vi's side. So holding on to these two guns is crucial right now for NaVi. It's huge that Edward and Zeus actually make it out of there alive right now, because as we can see, Starks has enough to full buy on himself. Guardian still has enough to be able to drop one rifle for a teammate and get an AWP. That was going to be the thing. If they lost those two rifles, it may have been even just Guardian buying a random AWP or something like that and NaVi having to throw a curveball.
Yeah, definitely a little bit scary here. I mean, and that was basically Guardian just missing the flashbang and walking into the site when three people were waiting for him. The fact that they left the B-bomb site undefended to begin with is not such a big deal. JW, some pretty good grenades on him here. Flashbang to follow. He's going to be forced away.
I could have swore that he was the dead man there, honestly. Because I thought he was going to be right in the blast zone. NaVi have been doing this fairly consistently on the B site. Seized and Edward stacking up one behind the other and just simultaneously throwing HE so that they pretty much land one on top of the other as well, the nades. That's why I thought JW, I thought if those nades got anywhere near him, he was dead. Him getting out with 50 HP, I think, is actually a little bit lucky. He must have been just like two steps away from it being lethal.
Look at Pronex. He's actually managed to sneak all the way up here, and that's not so easy, so this could be a huge opening. If Pronex gets one kill on any one of the three members in this A-bomb site, the remaining two are suddenly going to have to worry about apartment slope and the connector here, and that's just way too much. Starks is going to maybe catch the first people coming around. He spots a couple of them. Question is, when is Pronex going to pounce? His timing is everything right here. Guardian picks up the first kill. Pronex still standing his ground. Now he's going to walk in, and is it on time? He's going to go for Starks. He will take him down, and it's a 2-on-3. That's not going to work out. Guardian will pick up a triple kill, and I'm not sure. I mean, what do you think? Was he too early or too late there, Pronex?
I don't think that even Pronex has... Like, Pronex coming out of connector, yes, okay. Like, too early, too late, great. I don't think that was the big thing, though. I think just Guardian. He stopped them single-handedly from getting out of pit. He gets two kills there and gets the man coming out of apartments as well. Just Guardian not getting smoked off properly means that Fnatic lose that round, pretty much.
Oh, the double grenade again. You were pointing this out, that it's something that NaVi have been doing pretty consistently. And that's maybe something Fnatic should be picking up on soon, because right now... They've lost, almost 100% HP, actually more than 100% HP, and it's going to be JW down. Pronex on 25 here. That's actually a big opening for NaVi, and it's almost free for them as well.
That's massive damage, and Seize is going to find one. Wow. Seize is just having a field day right now for him to start. And this is a buy round from Fnatic as well. And this is a real problem for Fnatic as well, because now there's two guys remaining. And they have no money left. $0 on Fnatic. Practically the entire team. Nobody has bank on Fnatic's side right now. So Fnatic really struggling. They're going to be in a very difficult position. This could actually set up NaVi to just close out this half 13-2. Because Fnatic, they should have to eco here.
Yeah,
if not two rounds of eco. This is feasible for NaVi to just completely trounce Fnatic in the first half.
I mean, we introduced this grand final saying that last time NaVi were here defending it and playing against NIP. Seize just had a great grand finals, and as you can tell, he's 17-5-7, which in 13, or actually just 12 rounds, is not that bad. We're just now starting the 13th round, so we'll see if he can keep this up. They're going to go for the rush towards the... Actually, they're going to go underpass. I thought they were going to rush into those double grenades again.
Seems like they've learned their lesson eventually, right? Molly's going to go down, though. Flusher taking 10 points of damage. Zeus finds Pronax peeking out. Zeus is going to get his second frag. He almost gets Crims, but he's not quite quick enough. Guardian, however, will find a point-blank shot on Crims. And this should be the end of the story here for Fnatic. They get closed in on from all sides. And NaVi actually only losing one guy is not a big deal for them. They have plenty of money on their side of the map right now.
I mean... I guess right now, Fnatic, if anything, the thing that might calm them down was the idea that, alright, look, we have a one-map advantage, so all this does for NaVi is sort of bring it back on an even keel. And this is also, you know, probably not one of NaVi's best maps, so there's some things that Fnatic can you know, talk themselves into maybe a slightly better state of mind. But obviously, as Grand Finals goes, this is a pretty terrifying start when you're playing the home team as well, the team that's on the home soil, right?
No, absolutely. They're going to have a crossfire offset up here on the A side as well. Guardian will start off strong, picking off Olafmeister. Starks is still alive in CT spawn as well. He can lend a hand. if they try and make it to this site, Fnatic, but the flashes are raining in. Fnatic doing the best they can, and they do manage to overwhelm Guardian. Great shot from Pronex, takes out Edward. We lose Starx as well, and just like that, we're into a 2-on-3. Fnatic managing to get onto this site at least. They still need to get the plant, though.
Yeah, but they still haven't dealt with Psycho Seized, and he's going to be picking up 1, 2, almost gets a third one. And now it is a one-on-one, Seuss and Crimson. Seuss is really the guy, one of the few guys on Na'Vi's side here who hasn't been having, you know, a completely insane first map here. So maybe this is good for Crims, who's been already doing really well on Fnatic's side, and he's patiently waiting. He wants Seuss to make the first move, and so does Seuss. He's sneaking up really close. Crims is going to see the angle, but he goes down. Seuss picks up the headshot. Oh my god, that was the opening that Fnatic needed. If they got that round, there would have been a chance. Now instead, they have almost no money for the 15th round.
Yeah, that's a calamity. Crims, he's going to be kicking himself. He's going to be replaying that. He played it so well. I mean, he just had to sit. Because Seuss isn't going anywhere. He knows that Seuss is in that corner. And there's no way that Seuss gets out from around that corner without Crims seeing it if he just holds that line. But Crims deciding to take matters into his own hands. He even tags Seuss. But it's not enough. That's just, that's once again a big blow dealt to Fnatic's confidence here. And we go into the last round. They're going for another full out smoke onto A, just trying to close in from all different angles. But the rifles are on Na'Vi's side, and they're just brutalizing Fnatic.
Yeah, Molotov's down here. JW is actually going to get caught midair through the smoke. Starix with that shot now. Flusher with a deagle in hand. And in a 1-on-4, he's going to go down, and it'll be Edward with the triple and an easy defuse from Na'Vi. 13-2. Pretty stunning first half here in the Grand Finals. First map as well for Na'Vi. I mean, you never want to rule a team out too early, but I think for Fnatic to make this comeback happen is going to be insane if they can make it.
Yeah, 3 rounds is all that Na'Vi needs. It's basically pistol do or die. If you don't get the pistol, you're going to be in for a very sad time, Fnatic, because Na'Vi could just close out this map 16-2, and then what kind of statement is that going into a best-of-5 Grand Finals? That's Na'Vi evening up the series 1-1 right there, because Fnatic, because they come through the winner bracket, guys, if you're just tuning in, guys and gals, Fnatic have a map lead, or one map advantage coming out of the winner bracket, so Na'Vi, if they were to take this map, they would tie it up 1-1, and then it's the first team to 3 maps who net the win.
I mean, this is pretty scary, but I think it's way too early to be too much panicked here. Na'Vi would need to win not just this map, but the next one and the next one to win the Grand Finals. They need to win 3 maps in a row, basically, here. And that's not going to be all too easy, because the next map coming up, assuming that Na'Vi even win this one, it's definitely not said and done yet, but that would be Inferno, which is a map that I think Fnatic are much stronger on than Na'Vi are. And then we have Train coming up, and I don't know, I mean, yeah, it's too early to start celebrating, that's what I'm saying. And I think Na'Vi know this as well, but, you know, in case you're out there and you've bet your skins and you feel like, yes, I got my, don't celebrate yet. Actually, that's the second rules of skin betting. I'm making a list. The first rule, in case anyone's wondering, is never change your bet. That's the first rule. Second rule is never celebrate until you've won. Don't do it. I'll post the rules somewhere.
I think there's a lot to be said for that, and just, you know, regular life rules, right? Never celebrate till you've won. Kind of good to pay attention to that one and apply it everywhere.
Ah, yeah, we can make it like a general rule. I'll go with that one.
Are we gonna start like a little philosophy section on the site?
We should. I'd be down for that. I'd be down for that.
Alright. We'll look into that. I'm down. Let's get into the second half pistol here. Na'Vi and Fnatic about to clash. And Na'Vi, 3 rounds away from securing their first map in this best of five. Smoke rounds, or smokes going out onto the A site. It's a smoke round from Na'Vi, and they are just going to get in here and get a plant very quickly indeed. But Fnatic have been in the same situation before, the first time this team played in a best of three on this map. Yeah, now we have to see if they've managed to adjust.
There's a difference this time. They're miles away. Oh my god, Olofmeister does get the kill on Seuss here, and in the middle, Flusher goes down. And now Fnatic, I mean, they're backstabbing him. Olofmeister jumping, he gets the headshot on Guardian. That is so sick. Now, is he actually going to be able to defuse the bomb here as well? Seized is going to go down. Starix coming up from CT spawn. And that bomb is far ticked. If he gets the kill on the bomb planter here, he's wrapping around. He's going to get the one. And Starix, they can't do it in time, JW. Oh, no, Fnatic. So close, but not close enough.
Are you kidding me?
Olofmeister with some insane headshots, but it's not enough. They lose the round by, again, 1 nanosecond.
I thought it was going to go Fnatic's way that time. The split second, right? Either way, I thought it was gonna go Fnatic's way that time. It looked like they had a that was like a one billionth of a second right there. I can't believe it. Fnatic robbed. That was an excellent retake as well on their part. NaVi really pushing in aggressive into CPL, something we saw them do versus Hellraisers as well. So just trying to get in Fnatic's face, trying to throw Fnatic off guard, but Fnatic, they kept their cool. Pronex landed a couple of very nice shots, and they still can't do it. NaVi now on the brink of securing this first map in the best of five, 14-2 the score. They've got the rifles, and Fnatic, clearly, I mean, they've had to force buy here.
And to be perfectly honest, that's really, really, really bad for Fnatic going into the second map, because the problem is that if they lose this map but sort of make some sort of comeback on the CT side and they can, you know, stabilize a little bit, that's all right. But imagine losing. Imagine how soul-crushing it is to lose a round because you're off by, you know, a quarter of a second or something like that. That's going to stick with you for a while.
There is that, but then it's the same thing, right, Anders? Don't give up until it's over, until that 16th round is on the board. And yeah, Fnatic, this is the first map in a best of five. It's not even a best of three. They still have two maps to lose before they're out of this final. So Fnatic, we'll see how things go. I mean, they've got experience now as a team, and with Pronax's leadership, you can be sure that they're still a threat. NaVi, however, this is fantastic for NaVi. This is going to give them so much confidence going into the rest of this. Point-blank shot from Crims on Guardian will remove him from the picture, but Crims is alone in a 1v4 now, and he's only got the scout to do it with. And it's not going to be for long. Seized continues to just do so well, actually, on this first map. 22 kills for him. 22, 6, and 9.
Okay, so if the sort of the other side of the coin of that rule that says don't celebrate too early is don't give up too early, I agree that we can make that a third rule, but the problem is that it's a lot easier not to celebrate too early than it is not to give up too early. I mean, that's a really hard rule to follow, because it's just like, again, basic human nature. You feel that defeat coming, and you know, you've got to stick with it.
You know what we'll do is we'll go ahead and interview NiP. Because if ever there was a team that don't know, like, how to give up, basically, it's NiP. And this finals at Gamescom pretty much paints the picture. Hell, the quarterfinals, the semifinals, the finals. NiP are the poster children of that saying.
Yeah. It's almost at the point where we feel like if NiP had lost just one more round at any random point during the whole tournament, they would have been a different outcome. Flusher with a really nice one deke. He's going to go overseas as well. Can't take him down, but Fnatic are going to win this round anyway. It's 2-on-4. And after this, they're going to need to win 12 rounds in a row to force the overtime end. Actually, that can be done. That's just something that's really worth keeping an eye on here. You can win 12 rounds in a row on a map like this. I would say right now, Fnatic are in a tough spot because they don't really have the weapons for it. But if they win a couple of rounds in a row, force a Nico on NaVi, and then pick up, let's say, AWP and Auto Sniper, who knows?
Oh yeah, they could. I mean, they can, of course, turn it around. AWP, Auto Sniper, we've seen them put it to good use. You've got two fantastic offers on Fnatic, JW and Olafmeister both. And Pronax has even kind of played around a little bit with the Auto Sniper, with the SCAR 20. So we can see anything out of Fnatic. It's a question of them just holding off NaVi, because NaVi now have, basically, they have 12 tries at winning this map. That's a long time to hold out if you're Fnatic for overtime. And NaVi, you know, they're going to go ahead and get it here because they've gone ahead and forced up.
A good shot from Crims, right at the edge of the smoke dam. Takes down one NaVi member before the push even happens, so that's really great. And they have three members here for Fnatic. They have a good setup to deal with the incoming push from the terror side, so they might be able to do this.
Zeus gets swatted out by Crims, nicely done, and Crims is going to go forward and try and spray it down. JW is going to be the one to pick up the frag, and now it's going to come down to the push from NaVi straight out from A pit, and they are managing to find one kill. A second one could go down to Olafmeister. Crims is gone. Olaf is just barely hanging in there by a thread, but Starks and Guardian are beat up as well. 40 seconds left, and NaVi are already going for the trick play. They want to get that bomb over to that B site.
This is a really cool idea, but I'm wondering why Guardian is looking for more kills right now. He should be waiting. Let them come until Starix has basically put down the bomb, but Starix is going to go underpass as well. So this is like, what, a double mind game? I have no idea what's happening at this moment. He's going to be walking up behind Flusher, and he actually might just catch the kill on him. He does miss, but there it is. Back into a 2-on-2 now. The ultimate mind game would be him running back to B. Guardian still in here looking for Olafmeister, who's very low on health. Well, he's going to be alone, Guardian, with 6 seconds left, and that does seal the round. Interesting. Interesting.
Man, Olafmeister actually lets him get away. Well, Olafmeister gets the kill. You'd much rather get the kill on Guardian than rather than let him hold on to that AK. So, Good kill there, and Fnatic actually weathering the storm. Pronax playing a very nice position in window CPL, stopping Starix. You got to give NaVi credit for actually trying to come up with something like that. If Starix had an extra 15 seconds to work with, which is a lifetime, but if you had an extra 15 seconds to work with in that sort of scenario, it could very well have happened, because basically Pronax is in the best position because Starix doesn't have time with 10 seconds left to check CPL and root Pronax out of there.
Well, it's going to be an eco into the bomb site here, and bomb is being planted right there, and they can actually stop it, so that's actually already a win for NaVi in this round. Don't think they can keep the bomb site as it is. They do have one rifle stolen here, but that's probably not going to be enough.
JW is trying to close gaps here. He's got the P2K. We'll find the shot on Seized. Zeus is going to get taken out as well, so that rifle not really going to work, going to use. And Starix... once again, Starix is on a mission. He's run all the way through AAPS, back into T-spawn, and now he's in A-pit. Is he going to get to find a kill because of this? He's got the CZ. Oh, takes a shot at Crims, and... oh, he gets the long-range headshot on Flusha. Well played.
That's going to be super annoying, right? I mean, it doesn't make a big difference in terms of Fnatic. They really... they're not going to eco at any point, right? They lose a round, they lose the map. So, it's just still annoying, isn't it? And now there's the double up setup, and this is where I'm thinking, you know, 10 rounds in a row for Fnatic? I wouldn't rule it out. I really wouldn't. It's unlikely, it's highly unlikely. But, I mean, it'd be one hell of a comeback if they do it.
Oh, it'd be one of the sickest comebacks in CS history, flat out. If you could manage this kind of comeback, yeah, that goes down in the annals of CSGO. In the history books, you know, little CSGO kids when they're at school and you're teaching them, you know, this is how you defuse a bomb, and then it's history class. This is definitely going to be one of those maps, if it happens, that is mentioned and that you get graded on. Because you better damn well remember that the G-Rex was present. Ulfmeister manages to get Zeus early on, and there's the double op play already going into play, or you know, being used.
Yeah, and then Ulfmeister with supreme confidence, pushing up even further than he was before, and ready to see if he can take down Starix. And Starix really shouldn't be expecting this, but it seems like he is. Still not enough. Ulfmeister will get another kill, and Pronax in the meantime also taking down one. Guardian in the middle. It's going to go down to Flusha, so this is a complete shutout. Fnatic really controlling the map well here. And Edwardson alone in a 1-on-5.
Edward is alone in a 1v5. Ulfmeister is getting support now, but he's not going to be able to make it out of there clean. So that's actually a very nice kill for Edward to pick up there. Question is Flusha going to let him get away in one piece? Edward taking his time with it, doing a bit of a scream impression, going for the clicks. Flusha baits him out. It's the duel. And Flusha is just standing his ground. Where is the flank? Crims. Crims could be walking right up behind Edward.
Yeah, I was wondering if they were going to try and knife him, because they've got him boxed in. Edward will pick up the kill. He can't really put down the bomb in time, unfortunately. He's going to try and run for it here. And there won't be enough time, and especially not with Pronax waiting with a headshot from the AK. That was still a pretty interesting and slightly tense situation, but we're at 15-6. Continuously map point here for NaVi, but the double up setup still lives. And NaVi with no bomb plant are going to have to eco again.
But they still have so much room to work with. It's not the end of the world for NaVi. I'm just like curious as to why Crims... like, I guess Flush was just saying, leave it to me, leave it to me, leave it to me. And, you know, I guess Crims and, you know, the rest of them were like, okay, man, well, you know, you go ahead, you get your crack at it, right? I feel like Crims could have worked up behind Edward much faster, especially with Flusha keeping him distracted that way. JW with a nice shot already to start things off. Clear Starix out of A apartments. And mid is about to be contested, but Flusha's already found Guardian. And Flusha just continues to dominate.
Oh yeah, they will be taken out by Seized, who's going to go down immediately afterwards to JW. And I think the only thing that really matters for Fnatic at this point is the fact that they can keep onto the orbs, just so they don't have to rebuy them and lack grenades. But as long as the two orbs survive, I don't even think it matters anymore how many Fnatic members are lost.
No, it's not a stretch. They want to hold on to these guns. Hell, if Flusha... or if they decide to pick up like a SCAR 20 or something and really go to town, it'd be kind of overkill. I think it's better that they have the three rifles than really getting fancy and trying to pull a Titan or something. But we have seen Titan do that in the past, right? With mixed results. So it is an option. I just don't think Fnatic are going to go for it, really.
Yeah, I mean, it depends on what style you want to play, right? I mean, obviously, the great thing about the orbs is that they can be all the way in the back and everything, but on a map like Mirage, you could get smoked out, and the fact is, NaVi just need one round where they have a good entrance into either A or B, put down some smokes, put the bomb down, and victory is theirs. It's really not a lot that they have to accomplish here, NaVi, but so far, they've been playing 5 rounds in a row without winning anything, and Fnatic are looking for another 8 in a row.
Yeah, Fnatic looking for another 8. entirely possible. We can't count it out. But now NaVi are going to get two cracks at it, basically, because they have enough money after a full buy. Next round, if they were to lose it, they still have... Well, I mean, if they lose it, you know, if they win, they win, right? But if they lose, you know, they're still going to be able to buy. So that's big here for NaVi. But it looks like it's going to be just a straight-up smoke round here from NaVi. They're going to make another attempt, despite how Fnatic have been so good about dealing with this with the retakes. Here it comes, the push from NaVi.
JW is really close with the AWP, which is really interesting, but also very JW-esque. He's always going to pick up the first kill, does miss a bit of a grenade there, and he's still going to pick up another one with the CSET 75. Misses the next flick, but it should be just fine anyway. Crims is there to close out the round, and that's going to be just Flusher dying, leaving it at 15 to 8 here. What's really, I mean, that was scary because JW was actually up in the apartment early on, and when he came down to shadows as well, that could have been a slightly awkward position, but then again, that's the kind of, you know, distance we do often see JW using that rifle at.
Oh, he has, he's like Kenny S. He's got no problem working up close with that AWP, that's for sure. And when JW is on point, he can pull off just six shots like Guardian, Kenny S. Those guys who are able to just go for crazy flicks. The reaction time on these guys is obscene. But right now, NaVi again going for the buy. Guardian has that AWP, but Flusher will find Edward at top mid. And JW is opping currently as well. Guardian going for a bit of a boost box or a boost up on the boxes. And JW still finds him on the edge of the boxes through the smoke. JW hunts Guardian down. And Fnatic have yet to take a point of damage here.
Yeah, and it's also JW's fault that they got the kill on Edward. Seuss will take down JW, who has actually stopped paying attention to the middle. So a little bit of a risk here, but it's still a 4-on-3. Olaf Meister looking towards the ramp. Actually, unscopes just at the wrong time, but he's still going to pick up the kill when he turns back around.
Right now, NaVi need to just find an entry here. Flusher getting dropped dangerously low, and there's Zeus, but Crims on connector. And the issue here is that every time NaVi try and take a fight somewhere, it seems like Fnatic have got the second step behind it. You know, Crims is there to cover it up. Crims will lock out Starix. But Fnatic are getting very good about just holding and overlapping angles right now, so that, you know, it's Crims from electric and Flusher from short. If Flusher or Crims goes down, you have the other guy who's stepping in, who's constantly applying pressure to NaVi for the refrag. So Fnatic right now are playing very nice CS. NaVi are the ones who are heavily pressured. And NaVi, are they going to go for a buy? I don't think so. I think it's just going to be one of those solo AK plays here, a la Hellraisers.
Yeah, but it's slightly less crazy than Hellraisers because Edward can still buy just fine in the upcoming round. So this is just leaving like a slight chance for them to get something done. Seuss is going to go down immediately though. But I don't mind this as much. This is not quite Hellraiser's level of insanity.
Oh, I love the double flash coming out from Fnatic as well, from B and A towards mid. Just white out the entire area and see if there's going to be an opportunity to take advantage of it. Crims is just wreaking havoc though right now. Finds Edward Starks, Guardian, Crims. He's out to get his NaVi collection. There's one guy left and he's out to catch them all right now.
So what I would say, regardless of how this ends up, I mean, obviously, you know, there's nothing we want more than overtime in a Grand Finals. That'd be amazing. But even then, even without overtime, even if NaVi end up winning it at, you know, whatever, like 16-10 or something like that, it still is, they've still done so much right now, Fnatic, to mentally get back in this. That's an ace from Crims as well in this eco round, or the anti-eco. So that's really great, a great job from him. But I think Fnatic have managed to, nothing else, prove to themselves, and I guess to everyone else, that They're perfectly capable of dealing with NaVi, and that's good.
Oh, they are.
That's really good.
This is what I was talking about at the beginning of the series right now. The longer that NaVi take to close out this game, the worse it gets for them going on into the series. Because what we're seeing right now, Fnatic, they believe they can take this game. But for them, this game is mainly, if it happens, awesome. If not, we're going to play as hard as we can to warm up and get into the zone. And right now, the more rounds that Fnatic pick up and put on this board, it's just going to get harder and harder for NaVi, because now we're starting to see Crims start to come alive. Olafmeister's landing shots. So is JW. They're starting to get the juices flowing because they haven't played a best of three yet today. This is their first game of the day, Fnatic.
Cronax in his favorite position actually trades with Seuss. Grenade for a M4 shot. And I think Seuss must have heard him running, so I'm not sure why he hesitated that much when he went for the first peek. But, I mean, actually, overall, that's going to work in favor of NaVi, but it's a position that Pronax has been pretty happy about using in the past on Mirage.
Absolutely. It's kind of his go-to spot now. We should be just calling that the Pronax spot, because he really has been making a lot of use of it in particular. NaVi, however, they know. And they've definitely, they'll have taken note. JW will find Starix peeking up in B apartments. Flusha is here on short to help as well. Nade is going to go in. That should take out Sazed, and yes, it does. The remaining two members are getting bogged down here. They need to find a shot fast. Edward peeks out, and Flusha says hello, but Edward says hi right back.
JW is actually going for no scope jumping shots here, which is a bit of a risk right now. That could have been really dangerous, and that's actually something I don't want to see from JW, because he was already doing well. He already got the leg shot on one and then the grenade to follow up, and I don't think he had to do that, because what if he had gone down? It would have been a one-on-one between Guardian and whoever else was left, so... Yeah, I mean, I understand why Fnatic are feeling giddy right now. They're only four rounds away from forcing the overtime here, but they really can't afford to make mistakes like that.
No, that they can. I mean, that's the thing. If they threw it away, especially, I mean, if they threw it away on a mistake like that, that would be heartbreaking. I think we have a pause coming in right now. Not sure.
Yeah, I had a little bit of a hiccup, and for a moment I thought maybe the stream was dropped, so I almost panicked, but it seems to be working just fine. My God, that's the most scary thing, especially in the grand finals. You know, knock on wood and all that stuff. You don't want anything to happen. So look, guys, while we do have the pause, a big welcome to everyone who's joining. This is insane. We've got 57,000 people watching, so big thanks and big welcome to all of you. I hope you're going to follow the channel if you enjoy the content that's on here, because we're just about 4,000 followers shy of the 200,000 mark, which we've been gunning for a while. So we do appreciate that. And also, we are going to do a subscriber giveaway a little bit later on for our lovely sub team. It's going to feature one of these StatTrak AKs. And also one of these Cyrexes that we've got gifted from Stony. So let me see if I can find it. There we go. So one of these Cyrexes we're going to be giving away as well. So two lucky subs can win. Big thanks to everyone who's tuning in, of course. And right now, I mean, in terms of pausing, I think this is probably going to help out Na'Vi a little bit more than it will Fnatic.
Yeah, this is, I mean, right now, this is allowing Na'Vi to basically talk it over. I wouldn't even be, unlike in Gamescom, in case you guys watch Gamescom, per map, each team was allowed 1 3-minute timeout, right? I don't think that we have the same rules in Star Series, but this is definitely helping Na'Vi more than it is helping Fnatic. Because Fnatic now, you know, they were starting to get into that zone, into that, you know, that killer instinct was coming awake, and they were starting to really just being able to go through Na'Vi. Na'Vi, however, have had now a minute and a half, 2 minutes to talk over what is going on and to figure out how they need to handle Fnatic. And I think this helps. This definitely helps Fnatic or Na'Vi more.
I agree. I mean, hopefully, for Fnatic's point of view, they haven't lost the mojo here, because they've already had such an impressive second half here. I mean, how many rounds are we talking? I think it's 9 rounds in a row right now for them. So they've done an insane job so far. That's just really sick. And now they're only 4 rounds away. But I would say this, in terms of comebacks, the absolute hardest rounds to win is the one where you're at 15-14. That's usually where we see teams break, because everything is so high pressure, right? So that's... I mean, I'm not saying that will happen, but Fnatic are a pretty strong team mentally too, I think, but it's... That's where it gets really scary. We're going to go for an A push this time. Na'Vi pushing in. Crims is flashed, and he's going to go down and return frag instantly. And SJW taking down Guardian. C-Set is going to take down Edward, but it's still a 2-on-3. No bomb plant happening yet. Starix very close here. And actually, he's going to be alone as well. 1-on-3. He's going to go down. Flusher and JW saving the round and making it 15-12.
Oh, very, very nicely done there. JW in particular hit a blinding shot to start and then got the CZ out and got a second kill. So really nicely done there by JW holding in CPL. Crims as well. And there's the pause that got called for. But Fnatic with yet another solid hold. Like Olaf Meister, everybody really kind of lending a hand here. And we're starting to see that in the scoreboard as well. It's not just one guy sitting at the top of the scoreboard. It's, you know, it's really starting to spread out a little bit. But it seems like Na'Vi... I mean, they're going to have to eco here. No plant that round. Sure, they've lost now 10 in a row, but no plant means they actually have to eco to get another full buy on the board, because they're only going to have a couple more buys left before it's overtime, and Fnatic are right there.
Yeah, and, you know, now they have to think about how many different strats are they going to want to test in the last couple of rounds here before it's too late, basically, to try anything. And I would love... for them to go for some sort of rush to the B bomb site, because Fnatic have been playing with just one guy pretty aggressively over there, and I think it'd be worth it to try and do that. This eco round doesn't work out for Na'Vi, wasn't even actually close. They got a couple of kills, but that doesn't matter all that much. They have plenty of money this round, a whole lot of money to work with. They're gonna be able to buy this round and the next one, and probably the last one as well, because they have that round loss bonus going on. But yeah, I think a rush to B right now could work. I mean, they might lose a guy early on to the AWP, but with the right flashbangs, they might just trade evenly and then get the bomb down.
Do you want to put... Yeah, that's the scary thing, though. It's like, do you want to put it all on a rush? Granted, it's not the last round, and you have money to buy in the next round as well. A rush could be what catches Fnatic off guard, and Fnatic are no longer doing the double op either. Olafmeister is back to an M4A1, only JW sporting the sniper rifle for Fnatic right now. But right now, NaVi, four members gathered up towards A, everybody getting in the smoke positions. The bomb is still dropped in T-spawn, however, so this shouldn't be happening unless this is a fake? Like, they need to go back and pick up the bomb now? What is... NaVi are just going for a fake, I think. There's no way they're following up on this.
No, they are going to call back, but the big thing is... Pronax hears this. Look at him looking into the wall. It's not because he's wall hacking. He was using... Because when you look at something, you can hear it better. You can hear which direction people are running to. So he's just learning everything right now. And this is great. Actually, he got spotted by Seuss, and that's really big. I'm sure Seuss saw him then.
Yeah, you saw the instant stop. Look at this. Seuss, Edward. Now they're hunting. Now they know. And the game is up. 56 seconds. And hello, peekaboo, Edward. Quick one-for-one trade. But still, the game is up right now. NaVi now have used a lot of their nades. Or at least, no, they still have a couple smokes and a couple flashes, but they used quite a few nades to go for this fake, and now they've been kind of caught in the middle red-handed. Where do they go from here?
They're still bringing the bomb over to B, and if they can kill Flusher here, these last two people on A could do a lot. They're going to get the kill on JW. Flusher, is he going to rotate out? He is moving away, and that's a big mistake. Cease is going to die in A. There's still one guy left. Starix just has to survive. He doesn't have to get any kills. Just stay alive and be a distraction. Flusher, it's all down to him right now. This is winning the map or losing it altogether. He's going to pick up one, and now Guardian is alone. One on three, picks up the bomb, and Flusher will go down, but it's too late. He did his job just fine, and Guardian shouldn't be able to win this.
Yeah, he's going to get rushed down by Olafmeister, but it doesn't matter. Krim's Olafmeister, tag team him on that B site. And Krim's moving in from short, will get the, will get the final kill. I can't believe we're here, Anders. This is an amazing game to start a best of five grand finals. We're in the 30th round now. It comes down to the 30th round, and Fnatic are now on the brink of one of the sickest comebacks in CS history.
Absolutely, there's no other way to put it. Really sick play from the Swedish team, and... I mean, this is just a real delight, isn't it? I can't believe that they've been playing so solidly. We see two rounds at the beginning of the half for NaVi, and then it's been all Fnatic all the way since then. And but like I said, very often, this is the hardest round to win for Fnatic. And they came close last round to losing it. If Flusher had gone down immediately, that would have probably lost them the round already. So yeah, we'll see.
No, no, you're sure, you're absolutely right. If Zeus, if they're thorough, right? I think NaVi got a little bit ahead of themselves that last round and didn't decide to check out the site. Now NaVi, I don't think they'll make that same mistake, but the amount of pressure on NaVi to finally close it out in the 30th round is huge as well. Fnatic, I think just slightly less so. NaVi are the ones who are just like, we have actually given them like 12 rounds in a row right now, guys. Why can't we get one more round?
And look at this, because JW spotted them in the middle, they pretty much know. They saw people running back from B towards A. They have the stack up here. I think Fnatic are about to take overtime. They have the perfect setup. Flashbangs and smoke terrain and intrafracts are going to be important, but right now Fnatic should be able to do it. And Edward's going to go down. Krims with the opening kill. This is big for Fnatic. Starix gets the one return frag, but it might not be enough here. Krims is going to get overrun, but seized us alone in a one-on-three, and he's going to go down. And overtime is in effect. Absolutely great performance. That's a really stunning result from Fnatic. One slip up and they would have lost it.
That was incredible. And now the perfect read. You hit the nail on the head, Anders. JW giving the crucial information to his team, and then Fnatic having four guys, and also four guys in a setup that is made to deal with those smokes, that is made to deal with that kind of push coming out from NaVi. Krim's doing his job marvelously, and it's absolutely fitting that he's sitting at the top of the board right now with 28 frags in regular time. 28-8-19 on Krim's is just stellar. Seized. Also doing excellent work for NaVi with a 28-7-22 scoreline, but just incredible that Fnatic can actually come back in that kind of situation, have two rounds at the turn of the half, and run it all the way back. It's amazing that they managed to pull this off, and now we have to see. It's going to be MR3, 10k starting money, but how does this go, Anders? Are Fnatic able to just continue being this gigantic wall that NaVi can't figure out how to scale?
I don't know. I mean, so far they've won 13 rounds in a row. Who's to say they can't take the next three as well?
Oh. Alright, did you catch that?
Yeah, JW just casually strolling up and taking down Guardian. Now Pronax is going to go down. NaVi very quickly up from underpass here. And JW wants to sneak into window and maybe pick up a kill. Seuss almost gets caught here. Krim's trying to make his escape. Could have died from running back here. And JW is going to eat a bit of a grenade. But is he going to get a kill in return? Not just yet. There,
there it is. Overkill. Overkill. Seized. Oh.
Did JW hit that as well? Are you kidding me? JW is hitting shot after shot here. These are big plays from him. He messes up his flash. That's unfortunate, and that costs him. Edward gets the punish. Brings it back to a 3-on-3. But Na'Vi are no closer to getting onto a site. Krims turns away and walks right into C's to his camping out A apartments. Olafmeister now knows, and he's holding in the perfect place to deal with this. Starx has no idea he's on the site right now. C's, if he walks out, Olafmeister's going to have a field day.
Yeah, this could very, very quickly turn into a 2-on-2, and even worse here. The two members coming in from Na'Vi are very low on health, and Olafmeister is a monster. He's going to take down one, goes for the second one, shooting through the panel, and gets a double kill. Starix now, 1-on-2, 28 seconds left, and Olafmeister's very low on health here, but Starix is prepared for it, not prepared enough. Olafmeister will pick up the triple, and this was even closer than they might have seen, because seized up in the apartments, that grenade that he failed, I'm pretty sure it would have killed some guy who was down in connector. I think actually Krims was on like 8 points of health. So that was a that grenade was pretty disastrous. I think Fnatic would have won that round if that grenade hadn't failed.
That's unbelievable. And it's all about, yeah, Na'Vi, if they don't miss that nade, yes, but Edward running out, like they didn't know that Olafmeister was on that side, clearly. And so Edward runs out, gets caught. Olafmeister finds the shot on Seized with the wallbang. I mean, just perfectly played by Olaf as well. Just incredible right now. And now Fnatic, 16-15. The streak continues. JW lands another shot on Edward, but it goes through the wall, so it's not going to be fatal. Edward living through this. Na'Vi put on notice now, however, and it's going to be smokes, flashes, bit of a Fnatic play, in fact, towards this A site right now with Zeus's setup.
Yeah, they're going to go for it again. I mean, this is not Na'Vi. They've been trying for quite a while here in the second half, and it hasn't been working all too well. Krims is going to take down Seized, and actually they're just getting dropped completely from this bomb site. They have no chance at all. Edward, who got tagged over at B, is now up in apartments and in a 1-on-5. So from a close round to nothing that even resembles a close round here, is Edward's going to go down to JW. Triple kill from the Swedish sniper. And, I mean, I don't know. This is just very impressive. Right now, Fnatic are winning 15 rounds in a row, I believe, if you count overtime and normal time. That's insane.
I'm in awe right now that they continue to have this streak like this. Last round of this first half of the overtime, Fnatic on the brink. Na'Vi have not figured it out. They have yet to figure out what they need to do to make it happen. And is it going to be underpass? JW point blank. And here you go. The opening for Na'Vi. They get the punish on JW waiting in overpass. And that is the entry going Na'Vi's way.
I'm not sure what madness drove JW to leap into underpass alone with an AWP point blank range. That's something you want to do if you're winning, you know, a lot. But right now, it's no chance to do stuff like that. Flusher will get the return frag, so his teammates back him up, but I would say that is...
JW's job, Anders. That's JW's job. That's what Pronax wants JW to do, pretty much. Go nuts. JW, you're a madman. You're cut loose. Go. Run free and do whatever the hell comes through your mind. And, you know, if JW gets a point-blank shot, at least turns it into a 1-for-1, then it's big.
Yeah, but it still wouldn't be worth it for a 1-for-1. I think that's too much, essentially. At least I highly disagree with that move. Pronax in here is actually going to pick up a kill on the bomb carry. He's going to go down, but backup is here. Is it going to be fast enough? This one round, if Na'Vi can pick up one round here on the T-half, that could be all they need. They're going to be CT in a second. Olafmeister charges in, does drop the bomb planter. Still 25 seconds and Krims now in a 1-on-2, and they should be able to get the bomb down here. They're not in the greatest positions, but they do have the men advantage. They have a smoke as well here. Are they going to be able to put it up?
They will, and that's going to cut Krims off effectively here, and this allows for better afterplant positions. Edward gets spotted out behind bench, but Starx is now in kitchen, and so the crossfire is real. He is going to be walking. I mean, it's almost an impossible situation at this point for Krims. He needs to find a way to turn it into two 1v1s, but if Na'Vi play this correctly, Edward just dodging around the pillar, doing exactly what he has to do. By the time, play the bomb, Krims now has to just go YOLO, and he goes for it. He gets that kill, but Starx is still alive in the kitchen.
There's no time at all here, so smart play from Na'Vi. Nearly impossible situation for Krims. I mean, he did what he could, but that's just really, really hard to deal with. And that's going to be 16-17. So in overtime, it's 2-1 in favor of Fnatic. We're looking for the first team to reach 19 rounds here in the overtime. That's the name of the game here. And I think that kind of move from JW, I would love to see that when Fnatic are up like 10-1. They have so much money, you know, they have like 16,000 on everyone. They can afford to throw away an AWP, and it's going to catch the other team off guard. They're going to be shocked that JW is really that crazy. But right here, if this is the one round that's going to cost them, I think that's something that needs to be sort of reevaluated. That could be really, really expensive for Fnatic. And it's not like JW has been playing badly. He's been playing out of his mind on all the rest of the map, pretty much.
It's not like they took like 14 rounds in a row, Anders. You know, I think JW kind of getting a little giddy can be pardoned.
But that's the whole point. That's like the whole point. That's the whole basis of this thing, is that he's been carrying them to taking 15 rounds in a row by playing not like that. So the one round where he does it can be really scary. Now, it's definitely not over yet. Fnatic just need to win two rounds here on the second half, and that is doable. I mean, they did it during the normal time. No reason they can't do it again. They're going to go for a really quick push towards this B bomb site. And actually, the setup is not that great here for NaVi. Flashbangs rain in. Edward's going to pick up one and two. A little bit more than he could have asked for. Still inside the bomb site is Guardian with an AWP, and he is going to spot out JW. It's a 2-on-3 right now.
JW's still alive, though, and he's holding the angle looking towards Kitchen. He's not going to find a target quite yet because both of those players are out on the site right now. JW spots a gun barrel, goes for the point blank, and he's not going to get it, but Olafmeister strikes and picks off Zeus. Only problem is Starks has now set up the position with Guardian, and Starks will catch Olafmeister as soon as he tries to make a play. Starks from short, managing to set up that crossfire, gets NaVi that first round. And this is actually 16k starting money. So NaVi, even if they were to lose the first round of CT, it's not that big of a problem for them. They're still going to have ample money going into the last round. So I do like that change here in this overtime format. You don't have to worry about the money. Now it's all about hitting the shots and the right strats.
We're at 17-17. The score is tied once again here, and it's only the first map. This Grand Finals is turning up to be something quite interesting. If NaVi win the next two rounds here, then they're going to win the first map and put the map score at 1-1. If Fnatic take two in a row, then they'd get to take the first map, and that's a great opening. Starix going down here. Guardian shooting through the smoke without a scope. Still going to pick up the kill, and Zeus will finish JW in the very last bullet. Oh my god.
What is happening? NaVi are bouncing back finally. It seems like they're coming alive here, Anders. They're about to get 18th rounds, although we can't count them out. Flusha finds the headshot on Zeus. Flusha finds the shot on Guardian. Flusha, he's brought to an end. Edward will hunt him down in the end, but it's still Pronax alive in a 1-2 position with 59 seconds left on the clock. And we're talking about Pronax, the mastermind, the ultra sleuth. How do you deal with this guy? You have to cut him off already, and Seize is in a good position to do just that.
Yeah, and all Seize has to do is spot. He doesn't even have to find him. I'm a little bit disappointed. I wish he would have looked up there, but now I guess because Pronax is actually going middle, Seize is not in a bad spot here, and there's only 35 seconds. Seize wants desperately to make it 1-on-2, but he spots him jumping down. 30 seconds. I think that the time is ultimately what's going to really kill Pronax here.
Yeah, that burned a lot of time, but if he finds Edward here, I guarantee you he runs straight to A. And Pronax now, he knows exactly where Edward is. The nade? Oh, that would have been fantastic. He goes for the shot, but Edward will prevail. And Edward will get the final frag of this round, putting NaVi one round away. One round away for NaVi from taking this first map of a best of five. And you gotta say, like, this has been such a wild ride, but NaVi, now they are on the brink once again. Can Fnatic get second overtime?
Fnatic have gone for a double up setup. They want, more than anything, they want the entry frag, and JW's up in apartments, and Olafmeister's over at B, and I love this position from Olafmeister. This could definitely get them an entry frag, but then again, oh, he's gonna piece up in the double grenade and down to 17. That's a big risk to take, but I guess if he had got the return, it would have been worth it. And on the other side, NaVi do have a double up setup as well.
Yeah, double up on each side is crazy. Olafmeister will get caught by Seize to begin, but still, Fnatic, they've got information, and they've got Flusha. Flusha, quick 1-for-1, actually, as Edward does manage to hunt him down in the end.
Yeah, great opening from Flusha, and he walked right up the ladder in the whorehouse and instantly got taken down. Seize is the only one defending this bomb site, and there are three people coming, so this can work out for Fnatic right here.
It's only Seized, but there is Edward in position to get here fairly quickly as well. Edward actually on a mission through underpass. The longer this takes from Fnatic, the closer Edward gets to getting a perfect flank off. Fnatic are going to have to strike so quickly here. They have to get out onto the site instantly. They're still Seized alive on short. He's doing his best to buy time for Edward to get into position. And there is one in Kitchen as well here. NaVi are constricting on Fnatic. Fnatic need to get this bomb plant down.
Yeah, and they might not realize Edward's up here. If he gets the opening frag, that's a 2-on-4. He's got the opportunity. He's going to take down one, and he sprays down two. And now JW, 1-on-3 here. He's going to get caught, and NaVi will take the first map. Triple from Edward. Look at the 30 bombs being dropped from Edward and seized, in fact. Not Guardian this time, not the other team. It's Crims and Flusher, and then actually almost everyone. There's really nobody who horribly underperformed in this game. What a sick start to the SLTV Grand Finals. 19-17 in overtime to NaVi. And that leaves us as a 1-1 map score here.
No, exactly. It brings it back to a 1v1-1. So now, first team to win two rounds here, as they are even. It's the first to three to take the title. But we are going to take a 5-minute break after that adventure. We'll be back with our second map, which is going to be Inferno between Fnatic and NaVi.
Yes, indeed. Stay tuned, guys. It won't be long. More action coming up here in the finals.